Welcome to another TCP walkthrough video. I'm Logan, and in today's video, we're going to be going over calculating estimated tax payments. And we're going to be doing that the SuperfastCPA way, which is diving straight into questions to learn the material. Now, if you don't know much about our strategies, make sure you go to superfastcpa.com and check out our free one-hour webinar training. We teach the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, and again, it's only 1 hour, it is free, and it will save you so much time struggling with your CPA process. Make sure you go check it out. The link will be in the description. Also, just letting you know, we will only be going over 5 questions in this video, whereas SuperfastCPA members will have access to the full 10-question video when we post it on the members forum. So if you like this, you can get more of it by becoming a SuperfastCPA member. With that said, let's dive straight into the questions. Okay, here is question 1. John, a self-employed graphic designer, expects to earn $120,000 in net income this year. He does not have any withholding taxes and pays all his taxes through quarterly estimated tax payments. John's total tax liability last year was $22,000, and his AGI was below $150,000. Okay, we don't know why that matters, but it's there. Assuming John's applicable tax rates and deductions remain consistent with the previous year, and he wants to avoid any underpayment penalties, how much should John pay in estimated tax payments each quarter for the current year? Okay, this is the first question of the video, and we might not know very much about how estimated tax payments work, so let's just dive straight into the answer to start learning how it works. Okay, and the answer was $5,500. Now, that does make sense, you know, 22,000 divided by 4, that's $5,500, but it looks like it's going to explain a little bit more to us, so let's read through this. Determine last year's tax, so since John's AGI was less than $150,000, he can avoid penalties by paying 100% of last year's tax liability. Okay, $22,000 divided by 4, that's $5,500, so he makes those as quarterly payments. But let's learn about the underpayment penalty here. To avoid an underpayment penalty for estimated taxes, individuals must pay at least 90% of the tax due for the current year, or 100% of the tax reported on the previous year's tax return, whichever is smaller. For individuals whose adjusted gross income, or AGI, exceeded $150,000, it's either the 90% of the current year or 110% of the previous year's tax. These payments are typically made in 4 equal installments throughout the year. If these thresholds are met through timely estimated tax payments or withholding, the individuals will not face an underpayment penalty. Okay, so basically, from what we understand here, to avoid getting a penalty for not paying enough taxes, you can make estimated tax payments, and to know how much your estimated tax payments need to be and need to total, you either need to take 100% of the past year's tax liability or 90% of the current year's tax liability. And then I guess if you make over $150,000, it's 90% of the current year's tax liability or 110% of the previous year's tax liability. All right, we learned the basics of this, so let's go ahead and go to the next question. Okay, here is question 2. Samantha, a marketing consultant, has an expected annual income of $100,000 from her consulting business this year. She also works part-time at a local firm where she earns $30,000 and her employer withholds taxes from her salary. At the end of the year, Samantha calculates that her total tax liability is $35,000. The withholding from her part-time job amounts to $6,000 for the entire year. Last year, her total tax liability was $30,000. So we need to calculate how much she needs to pay by the end of the year through estimated tax payments to avoid the penalty. So if you think through this, you'll probably be able to figure it out with what we just went over in the previous question. So if you want, you can go ahead and try. But if not, if you're kind of confused how the withholding from her job might affect it, that's okay. We'll go ahead and look at the answer together. Okay, and the answer was $24,000. So let's go through this. So to determine the total payment to avoid penalty, first we need to decide whether she's going to take 100% of last year's tax liability or 90% of the current year's. So last year's tax liability was $30,000, and 90% of $35,000, which is the current year, would be $31,500. So she's going to take 100% of the previous year's tax liability because that's smaller. So then you take the withholding from her part-time job, and you subtract it from the total amount that she needs to pay, and that leaves $24,000. So she needs to make $24,000 in estimated tax payments throughout the rest of the year to be able to reach that $30,000. So let's learn a little bit about this. What counts as a prepayment of tax? So obviously there's those, you know, the quarterly estimated payments, but it seems like withholding from a job can also count. So let's read through this. any overpayment from previous years that has not been refunded and is applied to the current year's tax liability. So an overpayment or a refund that you didn't get yet, that can count. Taxes that are withheld from your wages by an employer, yep, we learned that. Any payments you make directly to the IRS, including electronic payments, mail, checks, or online payments, again, that's the quarterly payments. If you have multiple employers and pay more in FICA taxes than the annual limit, the excess is credited towards your tax liability. So only if you have multiple employers and you're paying too much FICA because you have multiple employers, then that can count towards your tax liability. And then credits such as the earned income tax credit or additional child tax credit can be applied to your tax bill and may result in a refund. So those can also affect your tax liability and how much you need to actually pay. So those are some of the things that can count as prepayment of tax. But the most simple of those is your employer withholding from your wages and you making estimated tax payments throughout the year. Those are the most simple ones. All right, let's go ahead and go to the next question. Okay, here is question three. Michael had an adjusted gross income of $160,000 last year with a total tax liability of $40,000. For the current year, Michael expects his income to increase, projecting an AGI of $200,000 with an estimated tax liability of $52,000. What is the minimum amount of estimated tax payments that Michael should make to avoid any underpayment penalties this year? Okay, so this seems pretty straightforward, but there is one part of the rule that you're going to need to remember. So go ahead, pause the video, do the calculation yourself if you can remember how to do it, and when you're ready, come back, we'll look at the answer together. Okay, and the answer was $44,000. So you calculate 110% of last year's tax, and you might be like, wait, 110%? That's because his AGI last year was over $150,000. So again, 110% of last year's tax liability is $44,000. 90% of the current year's tax liability is $46,800. So even though it's 110% of the last year's tax liability, that's still less than 90% of the current year's tax liability. So he's going to take that. And so he needs to pay at least $44,000 in taxes to avoid underpayment penalty. All right, let's go ahead and go to the next question. Okay, here is question four. Sarah had a tax liability of $28,000 last year. Her adjusted gross income did not exceed $150,000. For the current tax year, Sarah estimates her tax liability will be $30,000. Due to an oversight, she only paid $6,000 each quarter. If the IRS applies a 6% annual penalty rate for any underpayment, calculate the penalty Sarah must pay on the underpaid amount. Okay, so this is the first time that we're dealing with somebody who underpaid. So now we need to figure out what the penalty is if you do underpay. So if you'd like, go ahead, pause the video, see if you can figure this out. And when you're ready, we'll come back, we'll look at the answer together. Okay, and the answer is $180. That's the tax penalty. So you always need to figure out what is the minimum amount that they should have paid. So 100% of last year's tax was $28,000. 90% of the current year's tax is $27,000. So they're actually going to take $27,000 as the lower of the two. And then you take the actual payment, which was the $6,000 per quarter times by four. So that's $24,000. And that means that she only paid $24,000 of $27,000. So that's $3,000 left of taxes that she didn't pay. So 6% of that is $180 penalty. Now that 6% is the current number in 2024, but don't focus on that too much because that is something that can change with time. So just know that there is a percentage given by the IRS that is used to calculate the penalty for underpaid tax. All right, let's go ahead and go to the next question. All right, here is question five. Evelyn had a tax liability of $36,000 last year. She expects her income to remain relatively stable and plans to use the safe harbor rule for estimated tax payments to avoid underpayment penalties. Just letting you know, the safe harbor rule, it has a whole bunch of things about it, but in this case, it's talking about, you know, making that minimum of 100% of last year or 90% of the current year. That's the idea that it's getting at with the safe harbor rule. Evelyn decided to make quarterly estimated tax payments of $3,500, avoiding underpayment penalty. So she did avoid it. At the end of the tax year, Evelyn's total tax liability turned out to be $36,000 as well. So it was $36,000 last year and this year. What was the amount withheld by Evelyn's employer? Okay, this question might be a bit of a curveball. It might be like, wait, what? I have to figure out what the employer withheld from this. But you can figure it out. Just think through this. Pause the video if you need to figure out the answer, and when you're ready, come back, we'll look at it together. Okay, and the answer was $18,400. So you take the total quarterly estimated payments that were made, and that was $14,000 That's the 3,000 times four. And then you take what was the minimum amount that they were going to have paid. And that was the 90% of the total tax liability this year, because they're the same amount. So 90% is obviously less than 100%. So that gives you $32,400. Then you subtract the estimated tax payments that were made. And that leaves how much the employer must have paid, because Evelyn did avoid underpayment penalty. So she made the right payments. So that means that her employer must have covered the rest of the estimated payments. So that's why $18,400 is how much her employer withheld. All right, we've gone through five questions in this video. We've learned a lot. Before we go any further, let's go ahead and do one more part of the process called pillar topics. Now, the idea behind pillar topics is that as you're going through the questions to learn the material, you will notice the topics and the concepts and the calculations that are obviously important because they come up in multiple questions as you're going through them. You see this in like three or five questions as you're doing your study session that morning. So you know that they're important, so you make pillar topics on them so that you can remember them for later. So let's go ahead and look at the pillar topics for this video. Okay, here are the pillar topics. Taxpayers, especially those with income not subject to withholding, like freelancers or self-employed individuals, need to make quarterly estimated payments. So again, most people, when they have a normal employer, their employer withholds taxes from their income. So a lot of times you don't really have to worry too much about having to make estimated payments. So usually this applies to people who don't have somebody already doing that for them and they have to make those estimated tax payments themselves. The safe harbor rule, which is what we went over, allows taxpayers to avoid underpayment penalties if they pay at least 100% or 110% if their AGI was over $150,000 the previous year of their previous year's tax liability or 90% of the current year's estimated tax. Withholding from wages can count towards meeting the estimated tax requirement. The difference between the total tax liability and the amount withheld must be covered by estimated tax payments. If taxpayers underpay their estimated taxes, they may face a penalty. The penalty is based on the IRS rate, for example, 6% annual right now, applied to the underpayment amount. And again, that percentage can change with time, so just know that there is an IRS annual rate that they use. And finally, prepayments can include previous year overpayments applied to the current year, withholding from wages, direct payments made to the IRS, and any excess FICA taxes paid due to multiple employers. All right, those are the pillar topics for this video. And with that, we've gone through the five questions in this video. Just one more reminder to go check out our free one-hour webinar training on superfastcpa.com. Again, we teach the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, and it's something you don't want to miss. Also, we only went over five questions in this video, but if you liked it, Superfast CPA members will have access to the full 10-question video when we post it in the members forum. So you can get more of this if you become a Superfast CPA member. If you liked this video, make sure to like it and leave a comment. I hope this was helpful, and I will see you in the next video.